Good evening, I'm Ashley Banfield. This is Primetime Justice. There are a few things that anger people more than a criminal. Randy Zellin and defense attorney. So is that the same everywhere?
No, it's not the same everywhere. But here is the thing. And if she screws up, because 18 months
that she's going to have are supervised therapeutic visits, and they will go on for the 5 years of her probation. That makes sense to me. That child will be 7 the next time she has any chance, if she has any chance, to be alone with him. Will she have a chance, Misty?
Well, to be alone? For you watch this deplorable 16-minute video. She likely will.
This, you okay? Randy says this is an appropriate sentence. You all right with
listening
that?
Listening to Prosecutor Rourke. That argument.
Put her away.
Absolutely.
60 days. Will she serve all 60? Will she serve all 60?
Probably not.
Well, there you go. All right, I'm going to leave it there, guys. We've got another story we're working. 4 kids dead in Texas tonight. The city of Amarillo, Texas tonight is mourning the loss of 4 kids who died in their own home, apparently poisoned by the very air that they were breathing. Former prosecutor, I cannot imagine any prosecutor in this jurisdiction looking at this man, this father, who may have spread those pellets under his house unknowingly, who now has 4 dead children. He himself, I believe, is in critical condition, maybe stabilized. His wife is in serious condition. Would they actually charge him? He's lost 4 children. Hasn't he suffered enough?
But that's, they have discretion, and that's the beauty of our system. And we actually saw it in our last witness, or our last guest.
Yeah, poison.
The supplier, that's an illegal substance to have in this country.
Captain Davis, do you have any idea who gave this father those deadly pellets?
We do not. We were only told by the father.
Air rage, sadly, it seems, is all the rage these days, because incident after incident, passengers lashing out at other passengers and crew members, more often than not sparked by something pretty trivial like seat assignment. And now, so here's the thing. You would think that the gendarmes would cuff him and take him off, and that happened?
I think when you look at the video, and I've been on planes, planes are a very jittery to DEFCON 1, but when you watch the video, when you talk
on airplanes that we've all, you know, been subjected to, have a look. Yeah, then people cray. I don't know what to say. I don't know what I would do if I were on those flights. I just want to let you know, though, it was S.I. and what he did and the turnaround and the hotels and the new flights and the new crew and the jet fuel they had to jettison because they needed to land and it was too heavy. He owns a law firm because somebody said he was on the phone. I don't know how you're on the phone above the Pacific saying, get my dad's, get ready because United Airlines just diverted the effing plane.
I'm surprised he wasn't criminally charged either.
I'm not giving this guy another. Everybody's New Year's to be crappy. But I do have this other very interesting aviation story. It's kind of a head-scratcher involving United Airlines baggage handler. He just popped out as the workers opened up the compartment when the plane landed in Washington security. You think?
Absolutely. I think there's
a great question, Misty. And I'll tell you what, Randy, I have heard a little story about baggage handlers sometimes having naps in the cargo, or C, that you can't really be in some sort of federal violation.
Or D, all of the above.
Right. But it's by the way, he's in the heated pressurized compartment because at 27,000 feet, it goes down to about minus 31, minus 40. And very little oxygen. It's like being on Everest at 29,000 feet. All right. So there is this story that we're a bit bewildered by. An arm been stopped on the side of a road or a highway, and your car has been disabled. Turn the lights on. Because what happened in California on Harbor Freeway is nothing short of terrifying. And believe it or not, another vehicle, a cameraman inside it, happened to be rolling on this dark car on the side of the road when another car slammed right into it and then all mayhem breaks loose. Take a look. Later, and this is how the mom talked about this event after, when she had a chance to catch her breath, obviously, and realize everything's okay. They posted it on YouTube because they want other people to realize you need to secure your furniture when you have toddlers. This is what she had to say. Act of love. I guess the first thing I think of with a show like, you know, a crime and justice show is, oh boy, is that, you know, manufacturer of that chest of drawers in trouble. Yeah. And they've been in trouble before, right? If you don't brace the furniture.
It depends if there are sufficient warnings.
It's interesting. IKEA actually had a big dresser recall, 29 million of this same line. It's called the Malm, M-A-L-M. If you have one, please, please be careful. And this particular one in this video was not one of those, but apparently it was in the same line as the ones that were recalled.
And that's it, Ashley. So it's not only
$50 million before to settle 3 wrongful death claims, IKEA. But you know what? Listen, what's great about this story is that the parents decided to put this online so that other parents would see it and realize if you got little ones and my boys were just like those two. You gotta secure your shelves, your televisions, put the flat screens on the wall. Don't balance them on a dresser or on a table, because then little kids get into everything. And thank God that Brock and Bodie are fine, particularly Brock. And Bodie, you're amazing. Back after this.
Nature that he convinced these people to follow him and murder.
And murder too, right? Next parole hearing, 2027.
It was a loss of innocence at some level for this country, because it was beyond mortifying for people who may not have even been alive when it happened.
Manson is in the custody of CDCR. I can only assume that's California Department of Corrections.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
they want you to know that he's not
by the bracelets,
though.
Randy.
Yeah.
Well, we'll keep you posted on that, because if this is it for Charles Manson, it's the end of a very frightening and ugly chapter in American crime. Hey, thank you for staying with us. Thank you for sitting through that breaking news as well. I'm Ashley Banfield. Great to have you. See you back here tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Primetime Justice. Stay tuned. Forensic Files starts right now.